Thank you, thank you. Now, Mayor, Mayor and City Council, the reason I'm here tonight is I've been in this city for just about 30 years now. I never came up and complained about anything, but here lately, my light bill has just been outdated, and not only mine, but I sit with 27 people every Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday in dialysis, and all of them, they talk about the same thing. Poor people in this city, most of them average income is about $675 or $800 a month, and some are below that. Our light bills are running anywhere from $400, $500, some of them even $600 a month. We get 4 stitches a year for our light bills, and half of them used during the first part of the year. Myself, I know this year I had to use mine. I'm on 23 different medications, $1,700 a month for medication, and I mean that had to come first majority of time, and my rent. But what really bothered me, I called last week and asked for I had used all my extensions up, and I asked the young man. I said I have over half of my light bill, and I need a few days to. This was on Monday, and I told him I need to Friday to finish the rest of it. I'm sorry, sir. Your time is past due. You used all your stitches, and you have to at 12 o'clock to you pay your light bill. I said, well, sir, I sleep on the auction every night, and I need it. He said, well, I'm sorry. You have to by 12 o'clock or Tuesday, or your lights be cut off. Now, I mean, please, you can't tell me that this city can't give people extended light on their light bill. Now, I can't believe it. Much of we spend in this town buy and do another thing. And I don't see why in the world people can't have at least 8 or 10 extensions a year. It's not just like you giving them that. They're going to have to pay it. The light bill is going to have to be paid. I mean, I pay mine, and the next one pay that because they want their light. But sometimes you run in a snag, and sometimes you run short. But, I mean, I really, really hope y'all will look and say, look, let's help these people. A lot of people in this town need help. A lot of people in this town need help. If you just get out here and talk to some of these people, go to the, come out to the Dallas Center, they can tell you. They can tell you. People, now, we are people that we need. I need Dallas. That's the only way I live, with Dallas. I need the medication. That's the only way I live. But also, I need my light. I need my heat. Like the day I come in, I was about to freeze. Your blood is thin, and you need heat at times. When it's hot, you need the air. So all I'm asking you, if you, any way y'all can work out somewhere that people can get more extension. I mean, 8, 9, what's wrong with getting them 8 or 9 extension a year? I mean, if they don't pay it, it was in a certain amount of time, you're going to cut it out. But, I mean, if a man calls and says, I need 5 days, I need 10 more days to pay my light bill, then I don't see why the employer, I mean, the city down can't help. And so, I mean, I called Ms. Burt, and I talked to Mr. Pitt about it. And then I said something to the mayor. But I just can't believe that we live in a city that we can, you know, we just gonna cut the people out, especially senior citizens. People making $600 and $700 a month and trying to live on today and time. And that, I mean, it's rough. I know a lot of you never been in that situation. But I mean, you got people that are hurting, that are really hurting in this city. They are really hurting. OIC is a good example when passing out fat food. People line up for blocks, you know, trying to get things. And I mean, you know, but I'm just asking if any way possible, you see it in your heart to try to do more to help these people, the poor people in this city.
Okay, Mr. Vines, I think most of us have known you for years and years and used to be one of the best caterers in this community. And I want to tell you that I'm going to talk to Grant and our staff, and I'm sure maybe, I don't know, it's four extensions is, I think, the limit right now, but Grant, is there any way we can sit down and talk about that anyway, can't we?
Sure.
I agree with him a whole lot. People are in bad shape and hurting in this community. I mean, I don't know what we can do about it, but if we could just sit down and talk about it and see if it ain't something we can do. Okay?
And, Mayor, people that's on dialysis and this kind of thing, we won't cut their lights off. I mean, I don't think we will. Now, somebody down, some of them might told you that, but if they know you on that, they won't cut the lights off that quick.
Well, Council Coleman, I spoke to the gentleman. I've had a paper signed by my doctor saying that, you know, I need my oxygen to breathe on at night and everything, and I turn it into downstairs. And I told the young man that. And he said, "Well, I'm sorry, sir. You got to Tuesday at 12 o'clock. We're gonna cut him off."
Okay, give us a chance for that, Mr. Price.